Friends, today we the People's Movements organizations, the civil society organizations and citizens who care for the world, for the people, for the planet, for rivers, valleys and our own rights and resources are here in Washington DC before the World Bank. Will you be there with us? Listen, why we are here is because the World Bank, that is one of the most influential international financial institution, has been not just funding the projects and policies, but also changing the priorities and plans of our country. The land and other resources that belong to us, the democratic rights that are ours, and the civil liberties which are always compromised when the outsider's intervention and the alliance with our own governments go beyond following the values and the framework of our own constitutions. And the World Bank has been doing this all through. While they do have their own policies and manuals, and they do claim that they would safeguard the human rights and interests, we have learned from the Narmada experience, from the experience of the Arun Valley in Nepal, and so many projects in the Amazon and also in the Bangladesh, Pakistan and other countries. The South African countries like Ethiopia and Mali are also facing the same. The land acquisition, the forcible one, comes not only through the corporates and our own governments, but also is promoted by the World Bank's funding. As it happened with the 5% budget contribution in Narmada, they could influence the project to go ahead beyond the laws of the land, violating the rights, and the mess that is created is faced by the 250,000 people in the valley. And everyone is therefore screaming that you mind your policies and manuals and you follow those. We want our planet to survive. We want our communities to survive and survive with dignity. And that is what the bank's financial assistance really denies to people when it does not even follow its own manuals. Today, when they have brought out the draft safeguard policies, we the people's organizations and movements are going to question those. They have held a consultation and we are all for dialogue, but dialogue with dignity and dialogue which would be conclusive enough to say that, okay, we would change the policies as per the people's priorities and desires. If they don't do that, then the corporate experience with the neoliberal paradigm is going to be the same in the upcoming years, when the corporate powers are also engulfing the state, the omnipotent state in our own countries. So we want the bank to behave. We want the bank to learn lessons from the projects like Narmada, where it had withdrawn from. And we want the bank to understand that the environment matters. The environment is not just the climate with the ozone layer. It means land, water, forest to the Filipinos. It means the land, water, forest to the Indians. It means the cultural tradition and heritage of the African communities and the Latin American, the South American also. We therefore are before the bank today. After the dialogue, we will make our political statement, which would go beyond the borders of the countries and the nation states. And those would be our assertions of human rights and our democratic ecological rights. I hope you would be there. All of you, the citizens, whether those are formerly Indians or Filipinos, the Africans or the Asians, we would like you to be there to witness this event, which is a statement by the common people, the toilers, the farmers, the fish workers, the potters, the artisans, the indigenous people, the women beyond the caste class boundaries, and that will be the statement of the world. Please come so that there is no world versus bank kind of conflict to go on forever. The resistances are on, but we want the conflict to be resolved. We are positive, provided the bank is positive. Come and see what happens through the dialogue and what happens through our statement for the future that is going to support this people's politics and people's power to have the equity, justice, sustainability, a true sustainability at the bottom as the preconditions and the goals of the development planning in our countries.